Hello, everybody, and welcome to the EGF Rival Series Texas Finals between UT Austin and then UT San Antonio. I'm Roro, and this is my co-caster, Sandman. How you doing, Sandman?
I am doing great. I'm ready for some Overwatch.
All right, looks like we have a Widow coming out for UT San Antonio on the blue team. Looks like they're going to be on attack. That's not a big surprise.
Yeah, so on defense, they're going to have a Widow. That's not a big surprise. Robbie Mann is definitely a Widow main, so it's not a huge surprise. They're going to have to, but it looks like UT Austin is going to have some things to deal with the Widow with the Winston and Genji, so we'll see if Robbie Mann's able to get anything done with that on, with potentially both of those heroes in his face.
No, I saw Tchaikovsky for UT Austin on the Pharah, but I assume he's just going to keep the Pharah and not actually play Bastion for this, because this is looking like a dive comp with Genji, Tracer, and Winston. And that Mercy is pretty horribly out of place unless there's a Pharah.
Yeah, I agree. Although I do see, just generally, I see a lot more Mercy than I used to. You know, after the most recent updates, a lot more Mercy, less Zenyatta, Ana. I'm seeing a lot of Lucy, Mercy combos, but... Yeah, I'm not sure.
He hasn't quite let's ask.
I haven't seen anything in chat yet.
Oh, do it. Just do it. Control shift.
Yeah, pause for now. Because Shogun, I expected would be on the Ana, because that's usually what I've seen him on, but he hasn't picked yet. So I imagine there has to be something going on. So let's just make sure he's in before anything happens. Maybe his mom walked in. Yes, got to pull your pants up. I know it's easy to, you know, just play all out when you play Overwatch, but classic gank time, mom. Yeah, that tends to happen. Yes, it's a little spicy, a little saucy. But hopefully he's able to come in. Even just a simple R or something in chat will at least tell us that he's ready. Apparently, that's Robbie Mann's his mom. It's probably weird to have a mom that's a man. Maybe a little bit.
And also a Widow main, you know, like, those are some personalities.
I know, right? I mean, it's at least it's not a dirty Genji main.
Picks,
those are the people you don't want them. Excellent's trying to fish for some picks. Chat's getting a little weird here. It's taking turns that I had no idea. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, I should probably keep it PG. Yes, as funny as it is, probably should avoid that kind of talk, especially if we're going to be streaming it out to millions of people.
Hello to our millions of viewers out there. We are seeing a Bastion on offense, and yeah, it looks like they're just going to go for that dive and then have Bastion set up, destroy everybody with that Mercy damage boost.
Yeah, that's... I mean, he does have 5 seconds, so he easily could switch back to the Pharah. But I think it's an interesting pick because they don't have, like, a steady Reinhardt shield to go in the front, you know, to protect him. As if he goes in to try to, you know, get in position, he's pretty much going to get melted, especially by Robbie Man on that Widow. He's going to potentially just take him out almost immediately and keep it cute. I'm sure it could easily hook him in. So can't imagine he's going to stick with it.
No, I'm not sure if we should just restart because Shogunai has no time to walk to the first point.
Yeah, no, it's... So we're ready, Freddy, but I haven't seen anything from Shogunai yet. All right, I'm just going to restart. Okay.
Yep, that makes sense.
All right. So you got here, Shogunai still not picking anything. Oh, I had an emergency with my boy.
Now my game is just kind of...
Is your game weird now?
It is weird. Okay, no. Okay. Nope, I am good.
All right.
So we're here on Hanamura, historically one of the great equalizers of Overwatch, because this is just one of those games, one of those maps where it is very hard to capture a second point, but extremely easy to get the first point.
I don't know. Yes, on that, yes and no. It kind of depends. I mean, if you go with the Bastion, I mean, it's kind of hard to stage a very good attack when you go with a Bastion without a Reinhardt to, you know, keep you safe for long periods of time. So it's kind of a 5v6 battle in that case. But it's, if you can break through unless you have a very, very solid defense. Yeah, the first point is usually the easiest, and second point is where.
But I do think this could work out for Austin just because the dive will be very distracting. They do have three of them diving, and maybe even Lucio joining in. Who knows?
Yeah, it's that Bastion pick I'm still a little interested in, if he's going to actually stick with it or if he's going to, you know, just kind of troll us just a little bit, make us think that that's what he's going to be on. We're going to have to wait these last 10 seconds to see what he's going to do for realsies. Let me see. There we go. Okay.
Aha.
Aha. Didn't stick to his guns nearly long enough.
This has been a very strong dive comp in recent tournaments. Running the Pharmacy along with the Kenji, Winston, and Tracer. UT Austin going to be walking in. Excellent's going to dive onto the Lucio in the back line for UT San Antonio. And both teams going to be trading. Actually, UT Austin is going to be going up in this fight. Getting three picks as opposed to UT San Antonio's two picks. Let's see if they can seal the deal. You know, it's just going to be Snow sitting in the corner.
Yeah, it looks like they were able to get a couple good picks, but I don't know. I thought they could make something happen, but it looks like they were able to eventually take it out. Those respawns definitely allowed them to take that point there, but it was looking dicey there for a little bit of that push.
Right. I think it all just went downhill when the blue team actually just got so split up by the dive, and they had to scramble in four different directions. They were getting picked off.
Yeah, and Robbie Man didn't get a single thing done as Widow, so he is going to switch to the McCree, which I think is a much smarter pick against this comp. It's going to be dive heavy, but right now they do have the advantage, so let's see if they're able to make it work, because the Pharah is still going almost completely uncontested here.
Right now, San Antonio will be going up in fight, but looks like Austin's just going to keep holding on to the points. I'm not quite sure if I agree with that ultimate, actually. Oh, they were waiting for the res, and now it looks like this is going to be an even fight. Tarkovsky going down to keep it cute, however.
Nice boop there on the Reinhardt to get him points. That takes out your shield. They're able to get two ticks. That is good attack. Even if they lose it, they should be able to, at some point, stage another attack to get it.
That's a problem that's coming out of both sides, and it looks like UT Austin are going to be going up once again, and they're going to get the point in 6 minutes.
Wow. That was one of the fastest takes I've ever seen on Mark. I mean, that's a lot of work with. Get both points.
Now that res at the very end, it was that res at the very end. Sandman, you're cutting out a little bit. Are you okay?
Hang on.
All right, so yes, it looks like that res towards the very end. I didn't realize how close ERQ was to his res, but that res was able to get four people once Tchaikovsky popped his barrel ults, and a couple good ults coming out from both teams afterwards. I remember Snow Crash had like a 3 or 4 mine earth shatter, but just couldn't get anything for it.
Yeah, no, that was just a very good attack from UT Austin there, and I just don't know if they were overwhelmed on the side of San Antonio or what it was. I think, I don't know, just part of it was they didn't take out the Pharah, so the Pharah was able to take out a very important pick on the Soldier, and so that basically gave him free reign, and Robbie Man is still on the McCree, but there's so much more to deal with that it's hard for a single hit scan to take out a Pharah that's pocketed by a Mercy. So let's see if San Antonio is able to get, you know, a very quick attack here as well.
Now Austin are going to be running the Torb's Metra defense with a Winston, actually. I have some doubts about this running a defensive Winston, but it does work out when you have the right crossfire set up with between the Symmetra and the Soldier and Torb turrets.
Yeah, I agree, especially with the Zarya here to able to, you know, shield him up if he needs to jump into the back line. But I agree. I'm not a huge fan of Winston on defense just because the shield, while useful, doesn't have the same utility that a Reinhardt shield does. So let's see if they're able to keep it, because it's going to be Winston v. Winston here. So it's not quite as dire as it could be if San Antonio was going to run with the Reinhardt.
Right. And now it looks like San Antonio's going to be running a very classic dive with Azaria, said the Pharmacy. Going to be diving into the back line. Snowcrash able to pick off Diana. That's the only source of healing for Austin, really. And it looks like Austin's going to be able to hold the point despite going down several people. If San Antonio can just group up and rush the point before the Ana gets back. In fact, over half of Austin is coming back from spawn at the moment. It looks like they could just very easily take the point right now.
Yeah, see, because even taking out that one, too many were dying on the side of San Antonio. So even with the Ana gone, so the single healer being taken out on the side of UT Austin, there was not a whole lot that San Antonio could do at that point. Especially with Excellent jumping into the back line, taking out Zenyatta just like he did there. So that's taking out one of the healers for San Antonio. But it's kind of a skirmish going on right now. Not a whole lot of picks, but Bina is going to go down eventually.
All right, good tracking by Tchaikovsky to take down Shogunai. He was anti-healed, and now looks like Austin's actually going to be able to hold this with a reverse dive.
Yeah, a very good job by Tchaikovsky there. He was definitely definitely making those quench picks. The clench picks. I'm going to say quench picks, like quenchiest. yeah, he's doing a very good job.
That. I don't know if you caught that, but Robbie Man actually pulse bombing the teleporter and, along with himself. And switching over to Widow.
I did not notice that. I'm kind of sad about that. I would have loved to see that. I was focused on Tchaikovsky going very, you know, pretty deep on the front line.
Excellent going to be diving into Blue Team's back line, unable to pick off Robbie Man. Now it looks like... Oh, the Graviton going down from Tchaikovsky. Beat drop going down from San Antonio, and... Multiple ultimates going down. Shogunai's going to pop the Dragon Blade, and it looks like Bean's going to be popping his attack visor. Gets picked off immediately by Robbie Man. Great shot.
So it's a teleporter. They were able to put out the teleporter, but put out that Graviton. Interesting choice to use it there, but yeah, they were able to take it. Luckily, the Graviton kept them away from the point. So they're not going to be able to do it quite as fast as UT Austin, but. Everyone just kind of decided to jump off the edge, make sure they could get there in time.
Right, a very, very smart move. You don't see enough teams do things like that, where they coordinate their deaths and come back together. Austin going to be taking the high ground, switching over to D.Va, probably to bully the Widow.
Yeah, I think that's actually a very smart move to try to... Just like last time, don't give Robbie Man any room to do anything with that Widow and... If you make sure to do that, he's going to quickly switch off to something where he could potentially get more done.
Now, the Nana's going to go down onto Excellent. He's just going to keep going for this backline on San Antonio. He's just stalling so much time. Monkey Ult is just so good for situations like these where you just have to keep pushing the enemy team around, disrupting them. And now, although Red Team are up to not quite pushing in, now they are.
Alright, they're getting one tick. Okay, Winston is gonna jump in, but they managed to get one tick in there, so that is good for San Antonio for any future attacks if they're not able to make this happen. But it looks like they're gonna, you know, hunker down, make sure to get some good stuff done. Especially with that Zen ult keeping everyone alive.
Very good grab coming out from Keep It Cute. Now Robbie Man is just gonna go ham on this team. Sitting in the back with his Widow, their D.Va is not gonna be diving him. And a relatively quick take for UT San Antonio also.
That was very good. It was a bit more shaky on the attack than UT Austin had, but they really have nothing to complain about with 341, you know, managing to take that second point very, very quickly, especially after that slightly shaky attack on the first point. That second one looked almost effortless. So while they are starting with a whole lot less time, almost over 2 minutes, I think they should have enough time to get some stuff done with that.
Now it looks like... I'm not sure if I quite understand this comp coming out of Austin. Is this a reverse dive on defense? Pause coming out. Shogunai, his mom walking into his room once again.
Yep, needs to shut the game down. It's like, what are you doing? Nothing. His ping is nuts. Yeah, I know what that's like. Sometimes it's... it's one of the worst things to deal with when you're trying to play the game. Either people are jumping around too much or you're getting weird, you know, jumping spikes, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I was about to say, that's a weird code word for mom.
Well, Robbie Mann did say he was Shogunai's mom, so kind of makes sense. Cashews, pistachios, just throwing out random nuts. But hopefully we'll be able to bring him back in relatively quickly, maybe reset a router, which shouldn't take all that long, but because you don't want to go without your Ana player. That's you don't want to try to do that as a single healer. Yeah, it's with considering the time, I can't imagine, and based on what I've seen out of UT Austin, I can't imagine they'll have a whole lot of trouble getting at least the first point and most likely the second point. It's that 2-minute deficit that San Antonio's got puts them at, while it's a very quick time, and it's actually quite a bit of time to work with, it does put them at quite a bit of a disadvantage against Austin, which does have that just a little bit of extra time. So that's, you know, 3, 4, 5, you know, team wipes that they can afford to take that San Antonio really can't. So based on what I saw there, I would not be at all surprised to see basically a second, not a second overtime, but a second, you know, round to go and maybe 5 or 6 points instead of, you know, just try to make it up to 4, just because both teams have very good attacks overall. They had, you know, got the picks that they needed, were able to make some things work that allow them to take the point. So I would not be at all surprised to see 4-4 moving on to, you know, see if they could cap 5 and 6. But nope, Shogunai's back. All right. That's awesome. So we can get going here as soon as we make sure that he's all good to go.
I'm going to predict a 4-3 in favor of Austin, actually, just because they're changing up their defensive lineup, and I trust that they know what they're doing. They're probably making the adjustments to deal with Robbie Mann on his widow and the like pseudo dive that San Antonio has been running. Whereas for San Antonio's defense, there's just way too much time on the side of Austin. So I would definitely just see just a full cap once again from Austin.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see a 4-3 either, especially with, like I said, the time deficit just is so heavily favors UT Austin. But I was trying to be pretty optimistic with San Antonio's chances, just because I did see some good stuff on their attack, especially on point two. You know, even losing one, maybe two people, they were able to stabilize and get a almost not quite a team wipe against UT Austin, but some very good kills, very good picks. So we'll see what happens here, but as you said, Austin did change up their comp. No longer the Torbjörn, a bit more of a standard. Just the only difference is we're going to go with a triple DPS single tank.
San Antonio going to be running the Reinhardt. Very often when you run a Reinhardt, you just feel so useless when there's a Winston jumping on your team. Good Swiss strike by Tchaikovsky. Probably getting a reflect also. I didn't quite see the action, but that's just going to delay San Antonio that much more. They wait for Robbie Mann to come back from spawn.
And Robbie is going to switch to the McCree, which doesn't surprise me at all, because Tchaikovsky almost completely melted Robbie Mann in a matter of a couple seconds. He didn't let him do anything. So I'm really not surprised to see a McCree come out here, because the Widow obviously was not going to work.
Now, Excellent's got to be especially dangerous on that Winston, on defensive Winston, just because there is a Roadhog and a McCree sitting around. Just so much crowd controlling that you might just die instantly.
He actually is going to survive for a lot longer than I expected, but Bean is going to almost completely whiff his pulse bomb, but the team is able to clean up after that. So while the Tracer ult was pretty much useless, everybody else around him did manage to get some good stuff done.
Right, a very good mop-up coming out from San Antonio, or no, Austin rather. Just to stagger every last bit that they could possibly could. Now, San Antonio are going to have to try to figure out what they can do about this choke.
Yeah, it might turn into a situation where you just have to rush in once or twice, just go in dry, just to you know, bait out some ults on out of Austin, just like kind of like that pulse bomb there, and just make him either waste them or pull them out. And here's another one, a couple ults coming out from Austin. So I think this is exactly what they should have done.
Now that Nana Boosted Dragon Blade is just going to be tearing up this entire lineup for UT San Antonio. And unfortunately, Snowcrash whiffed his ult, his Earth Shatter, which is basically their only way of dealing with that. It's so hard as an Ana to hit an ulting Genji with that Nana Boost. You're just panicking. You have to wait a little bit to launch your Sleep Dart. And you miss.
Yeah, that's never a fun thing. As someone who plays lots and lots of Ana, that's really one of the least fun things, is trying to hit a flying Genji. But they did. Snowcrash did use his Earth Shatter on that fight, which I kind of disagree with. Like I said before, I think it would have been best for them to go in almost completely dry, just to try to bait out some ults. But they're trading right here, so they might be able to pull something out.
That was actually just such a clean dive by UT Austin. It was so instant, so well coordinated, that as soon as Exilent jumped in onto that back line, they were able to just coordinate their pickoff so quickly. But a good whole hog by Keep It Cute to hold on to the point against Bean, and they will fight.
You think Tchaikovsky might try to come in here, just bait it, just stall it out just a little bit longer. Oh, Excellent's gonna go in too, all right. So they can't have any real, okay.
forcing out the beat drop, that's actually gonna be pretty crucial, especially in these last 45 seconds for San Antonio. They have to make some really good decisions between now and then.
Yeah, and Robbie Man actually also going in, ending that fight with the High Noon, so that was two alts that they were able to bait out just with a very simple stall tactic. So I think this might be a very, very clean fight for UT Austin, using a couple alts just to get very nice cleanup.
Right, between the beat drop, the Dragon Blade, and the Primal Rage, they just absolutely crushed that push just now. And now it looks like San Antonio just have to like straggle to get on the points. Two more alts for Austin already, so it doesn't look like they're going to be quite able to work with the ult disadvantage. Snowcrash landing a huge Earth Shatter, Pulse Bomb going down, not landing on anybody, Nano Boost also going on to Snowcrash. He's just going to be swinging around on point. Let's see if San Antonio can actually take this point,
because it's not looking too bad for them. A Genji going against two tanks and a healer, that's not a very good setup that you want to deal with. And with a visoring soldier going against a D.Va, again, that's going to nullify that almost completely.
Very well placed bubble by Excellent, actually blocking off the source of healing for San Antonio for that much longer. But it doesn't matter, it looks like blue team will be able to take this point. Snowcrash getting pinned by Tchaikovsky, instantly getting melted. So low Earth Shatter.
Almost insult to injury there on that Tracer, but did get the job done, was able to take her out very, very quickly. So that was not what I expected, considering going into that fight, San Antonio didn't have a whole lot to work with, and they had all of, I think, 10 seconds to get on the point. Luckily, the soldier was able to get on there and start overtime. But I don't even know what to say what happened there, because, I don't know, Austin... I just didn't jump on the point to stall it out very long. There, a lot of them were up on the high ground, and they decided to stay there and shoot down onto the point, which allowed San Antonio to get quite a bit of percentage onto that point. You know, one tick, and then eventually two, because only one person dropped down onto the point, who they immediately died. So, very good job from San Antonio there. As I said before, I wasn't expecting four points. But at this point, who knows? You could see UT Austin be held to three, maybe even just two, depending on how well San Antonio is able to stabilize the defense.
Right. It looks like they're going to be keeping the Reinhardt and the Roadhog. San Antonio are going to be keeping those for their defense. And it looks like a pretty good countermeasure to the dive. They'll just have to hope that Tchaikovsky doesn't do too much work on his Pharah, because they only have one hit scan at the moment.
Yeah, so hopefully Robbie Man's going to be able to get some stuff done, but maybe Shogunai will be able to kind of pick up some slack, and just you know, land a pretty good amount of strategic shots just take him out. But Rodman is going to take out two, both healers. You can't really attack with that. So let's see if they can. Let's see what's going to happen here, because it's right now they're trading. So I don't know.
Austin is just going to keep trying to go on to this point between the Tracer and the Genji. They're just so hard to tie down. Missed hook from Kick, keep it cute. That's just 8 more seconds where there's just so much more harass coming out of Bean and Talonry. They're almost at their ults, actually. 74% on the Pulse Bomb, 72% on the Dragon Blade. Excellent. Just looking to scope out a healer.
But I think he just kind of gave up on that. Just went with jumping in.
Now okay, both teams are down.
Kind of a questionable Dragon Blade coming out from Talnori. I'm sorry, I'm trying to make sure I get that name right. Talnori, very questionable blade, because most of his team was dead, especially his healers. They were already taken out, and I think someone else was taken out in the interim. But
oh, he was switching out the blade there. Soldier, actually,
okay, all right. So that kind of explains it. But I was gonna say I was just kind of questioning the usage there, because you would not a whole lot you can do going, you know, 3v1, especially when two of them are tanks.
Barrage gonna come down, able to take down two for UT San Antonio. Rez gonna come down also. That's a very good tempo, Rez. Right now it's a 5v4 for San Antonio.
Yeah, so
Nakale asserting his mercy dominance over ERQ.
Yeah, a couple of good trades going on there, but you know, but just watching them, they're having a very, very good defense right now, especially compared to the earlier defense when I don't know that if they were overwhelmed necessarily, or they just didn't, I don't know, maybe they just weren't warmed up. Maybe they just needed those, you know, couple games just to kind of get into the swing. But right now they are doing a very good job of holding down this point, and especially with an alt advantage right now, there's very, I would think, very little chance that they're going to lose this point here, especially right now. But
right.
Who knows,
San
we'll
Antonio is just deathballing it so well. Oweki is just sitting on such high energy all the time, because Tchaikovsky is just going to be spamming with that Pharaoh. Sad. Rez is going to come out from ERQ, but good High Noon by Robbie Mance. Just mop up. But yeah, San Antonio able to answer the dive so well with between the Hog, the Saria, and the McCree.
Yeah, they're just doing a very good job. I'm seeing some very good things, and especially that fight when you saw a couple alts come out from the side of Austin. Almost no alts came out from San Antonio. You got the High Noon, but that was pretty much it. You didn't really need to see any grabs, no Earth Shatter, no Whole Hog, none of that. It was pretty much just, we're gonna, you know, just take them out. We're not gonna make a whole big fuss about it. We're just gonna do what we do.
Not a very good combo. The Graviton coming out from Wake Eve, catching three or four of Austin, then a nano boosted Whole Hog, just putting everybody through the grinder. And now Austin are going to be switching over to, well, they already switched over to the Reinhardt and the triple tank, basically, with a Hog and Zarya. Let's see if they can just play it better than San Antonio. Though with the ult disparity.
They're not going in with a Mercy. They're going to switch over to the Yana. And Tchaikovsky's going to take out Robbie Man, and he was probably one of their biggest heavy hitters on the defense here. So they might be able to make something work with this. Especially with an Earth Shatter like that. That's not going to hit anything.
That was a very good bait by Excellent, actually. Dropping shield to try to make Snow Crash use it. And it's actually very, very easy to react to when you hear the Earth Shatter sound, then you can just pop your shield out. It will block it.
All right, so it looks like they are going to be able to take this point. So it's going to be just under 2 minutes that they're going to have to take second point. And the alts are going to be fairly similar, although it's going to just go slightly in favor of the attack here. So maybe they'll get something that can work. Maybe they'll go in with a nano boosted Reinhardt or something like that. I'm interested to see what they do, especially with it's going to be a skirmish on the high ground.
Right, so Talnori is almost sitting on a grab, so I wouldn't be surprised if they've used this advice and nanoed the Reinhardt just so we can build up another Earth Shatter so quickly.
Yeah, that would definitely, I think, probably be one of the smarter decisions here, especially there it comes. Yep.
Nano boosted Reinhardt into the Graviton. It's just spinning in circles, whatever you need to do as Reinhardt, just hit everything with that nano boost. And well, that was a great wipe by Austin. Another solo.
Solo Earth-Shattered Tracer. Where did we see that before? All right, so I'm not going to call it prediction, but my optimism seems to be kind of paying off here. You know, so far it's 4-4 with Austin having only one more chance. They're only going to have a couple fights here, so let's see if they're able to do it, because I can't imagine San Antonio. It looks like they might be, but if I were them, I wouldn't switch up a whole lot of anything. I would keep what worked, because it worked very well. But it looks like they are going to go with the Torbjörn instead of the McCree, which, in my opinion, was probably the most dangerous piece piece of that puzzle that, you know, they put together. So, yeah, McCree was definitely the most dangerous person on their defense, and I'm surprised they're not going with it again.
Right, but we do have a Wakey switching over to Soldier from Nazaria, and it's just a lot less defense, but a lot more damage also. Between Wakey and Robbie Man with his turret, I don't think a Pharah play is going to be very safe here, to be quite honest.
Yeah, and basically, Mercy. Yeah, I know, that's what I was thinking. Without going with the Mercy, I'm surprised they're going to go with the Pharah. It just seems like a kind of a risky pick when you don't have someone pocketing you, you know, is as nicely as a Mercy does. I mean, an Ana can pocket a Pharah pretty well, but it requires a lot more attention, a lot more
great
lot better
by
aim.
My talent rate to Snowcrash is going to be going down finally after that initial hook. Excellent shield is still looking somewhat healthy. Can't always have a healthy shield when there's another hog on the other team.
Now when you have the damage that the defense is able to dish out right here, but Excellent just kind of going hammer time right now. And right, it looks like they are going to be able to take this point.
Now it's no surprise to me that he got his ult so fast. He was able to pin Shogani on that Ana really pretty early in that fight. He was swinging at Snowcrasher the entire time after he got hooked. And that will be the point for UT Austin and the game.
Yeah, it was kind of a situation where Excellent was slept right at the stairs by that point, and I don't know if they didn't focus him as much as they should have or what, but he was just swinging, no shield up, no none of that, and he seemed to not be, you know, he might have had both of his healers pocket him just to make sure he stayed alive, but I wonder if this is going to be it. Let me see. I kind of hope it is. Yes, it is. This is where I was saying he's just swinging. And they're not focusing him down nearly as much as I thought they should have.
That's just so fearless. He's got a great Ana healing and keeping him up, and like that's just such a dream as Reinhardt. You just able to swing as much as you want, build up your Earth Shatter.
Yeah, no, that's if I play with people and I usually play Ana, then they play Reinhardt. It's like, make sure to shoot my shiny metal butt. I'm thinking the Winston is probably gonna be here. It might even be a triple tank, especially from San Antonio, who's been around the triple tank more than Austin has.
Keep it cute. You're gonna be running the Torbjörn.
Torbjörn, all right.
Kale on this metro. I'm certain we're getting trolled right now.
Don't troll us. Come on, we're here for you. We're trying to back you up. Don't do that to us. Don't be him. But it looks like Austin is gonna be going fairly standard. Just gonna go with a pocket Pharah. Double tank, Tal'Nari? No, they're going to go single tank again, just like they did on the... was it attack? I think... No, I'm sorry, it was the defense that Austin put forward, which would only have the Winston.
No, it's actually working pretty well until San Antonio switched over to the Roadhog.
Let's see, so... Ooh, Awake Eve is now going to be on the Ana, so I wonder what Shogunai is going to go with. Ooh. Genji! Okay, usually I see a lot of... Not Ana mains necessarily, but people play a lot of Ana go to another hit scan. So interesting to see Genji come out from him. So let's see. Other than that, it's pretty much a standard comp from San Antonio. It's the comp from Austin that I'm a bit surprised with.
Now, Robin Man's going to be going down pretty early, but so is Excellent, getting anti-healed and melted down immediately by Keepy Cute. Mean's going to be getting another crucial pick onto Shogunai. This composition is not quite going to do the work that UT San Antonio is wishing for, because this Reinhardt's just holding shield and getting battered from all different sides, and that's just not going to work against a dive comp.
No, that is the one major benefit from the comp that Austin's running, is that they have so much damage and so much mobility that a shield like Reinhardt's, you know, only protecting the front, leaves everyone behind you and your own booty wide open for a Genji or a Tracer or even a Pharah if she's able to get back there, able to just, you know, pretty much wear you down. So
what an amazing flame strike by Snowcrash, sniping him almost like a third of the map away. Dragonblade gonna come out from town, already able to pick off two immediately. Yeah, it looks like Keepy Cute is just gonna be trying to hold the points, but between the Pharah, the Pharmacy, the Lucio, and the Tracer pressure, he's just not gonna be able to hold.
Yeah, if he was smart, not Kale would just jump off the edge right now, but I don't know if he wanted to be staggered or what. He's able to take out Excellent though. As he's going down, he's like, if I'm going down, you're going down with me. Which is actually a very good job, but not kill is going to be staggered. So that's going to bring it up to nearly 60% before they can even think about touching the point.
Now, Snowcrash still not switching off the Reinhardt. They're probably waiting on his Earth Shatter at this point. One of the few perks of Reinhardt against the dive comp is the Earth Shatter.
Yeah, I think that's... That could easily be what they're doing, because Snowcrash is—he's gonna go in, kind of go hammer. Nope. As I was saying, he was going hammer time. Tarkovsky's gonna go in with a far alt to take him out.
A good res coming out from IrQ, able to keep their team somewhat balanced in this next fight. It looks like San Antonio is gonna be trying to back out, but they do need to go in. The clock's ticking. Right, Austin's sitting at 95% right now.
Okay.
I'm a little points.
I'm a bit confused by that. I think they just weren't quite aware of where they were, but the Mercy Far of both just kind of went to the bottomless pit.
Nora gonna be popping his Dragon Blade. I'm not quite sure if I agree with that, just because it was pretty much 5v3.
Yeah, you were a man down. It was pretty much just you against tanks. There's very little you can do, even with the Genji Blade, which is extremely dangerous. But they did manage just now to pull out the sound barrier, so they did bait that out, even though it's pretty much just the Mercy on the point. So that is good for Austin here.
Pretty sure Austin needs to just step out right now and... Number one, stop building ult for San Antonio. And number two, just regroup and figure out your next move.
Yeah, I get trying to build your own ults, but at that point, you're pretty much just feeding. You're feeding their the ults for San Antonio, so not the smartest move.
Grab gonna be going down, only catching the Lucio, however.
Oh, no, Irk was caught in it, so they did catch the Mercy, so... That was a very quick early pick, not allowing a res to come out, so very good job. It only did catch one, eventually did catch Lucio, but taking out that Mercy, I think, was probably the most important pick, which they did manage to do, so that was very good. Not the best grav, I have to be honest about that, but Keep It Cute does already have 23%, so after just using it, he's already a quarter of the way to another one.
But he gets boofed off, actually, by Tchaikovsky, now... Final Rage gonna be going out from Excellence. He gets woken up immediately. I spent a good sleep by Awake Eve. Double two-man res coming out from IrQ. It doesn't look like UT San Antonio is gonna be able to hold this.
No, they were gonna fall with... Even with that... that early pick against Keepy Cute, I think, was very key. You know, taking him out of the fight 5v6. Shogunai is going to do I don't know what to call that, Mission Impossible jump? Rocket jump over that ledge to see if he can get on it? Not able to do it as Scott is there waiting for him, just ready to boop him right off.
Right, and Keepa Kill was actually pretty high energy when he got booped off right before that fight, and that would have been crucial. He probably could have built up another Graviton if he played his cards right.
Yeah, I think, especially with the new update, with the Zarya bubbles no longer preventing you from being booped from the Pharahs and Lucios, it completely changed how you positioned Zarya. Before, you could, as long as you had your bubble, you felt pretty safe no matter where you went, but now you're just as, you know, you can be knocked off just as easily as everybody else, so you have to kind of rethink that positioning. So that position Keep Q was in there, kind of a questionable one, but I think it's more of an ingrained habit to just stand there to get some, to try to, you know, land some shots.
Both teams choosing to run Reinhardts here, actually. Choosing to play the shield battle. Keep it cute. It's going to be on the hog, however, so excellent shield. It's not going to be very healthy for very long. In fact, it breaks right now.
Yeah, it's pretty much... So right now, it's pretty much even, but excellent's going to get a very nice charge against Snow Crash, taking him out of that fight.
Right, as soon as that shield broke, San Antonio had to go in, but in fact, Snow Crash's own shield was pretty unhealthy, and after that great pin by excellent, it just all went downhill.
Yeah, it was a very good job. That was taking Snow Crash out of that fight early was very key. But so far, both teams are doing a good job of melting down those shields. So far, neither team can say that they're having trouble, or they're having, you know, losing the shield war. The shield war is pretty much one for one right now.
Now both teams are going to be pretty even. Nano boost attack buys are coming out from Tchaikovsky. And blue team choosing to wipe very wisely.
Yeah, that was a smart decision to wipe, but one good thing that they can say on the side of San Antonio is that they did, I'm not going to say they baited out two alts, but they did have, Austin did use two alts there, the nano visor, so they could go into this fight and win it with a very, very solid alt advantage.
Right, five alts on the side of San Antonio. Let's see which ones they use. Maybe a nano boosted whole hog or attack visor.
So far, they're kind of playing a bit more passive than I think they should, especially with the alt advantage that they've got.
Now with the beat drop, let's see if they're able to get anything done. Yeah. Reverse beat drop coming out, attack visor coming out.
Very nice Earth Shatter out of Snow Crash.
A very good hold by San Antonio, or very, very good push by San Antonio. Despite the Graviton catching a few members, the Pulse Bomb not able to get much because it just got planted onto Snow Crash's shield.
But yeah, that was a very good take. The only issue there is now they have nothing to work with. They are going to have the whole hog come into this fight, but they did have to use quite a few alts to take that point. Ooh, but Keepy Cute's going to take out Bean. He's going to take him out pretty early.
A lot of good flanking hooks, actually. Choosing to play the Fat Tracer role. Shout out to Harblue.
All right, let's see here. I just want to make sure to press this button. Nope, wrong. Alright, there we go. Alright, Talnari's gonna kinda.
Keep it cute, you're gonna flank around again, not able to get the hook. And now the deck guys are coming out for Tchaikovsky. He gets instantly burst down by Robbie Man. What great shooting.
Ooh, excellent. Kind of tried to go in for that pin on Snow Crash, but he's gonna get taken down before he can actually pin him. So this looks like it is gonna be a solid hold and a desperation alt. Desperation Graviton out of Talnori. I'm very, very interested in that. I don't know. Maybe it was a Fat Finger. I don't know. Well, but
they were sitting on a Pulse Bomb. Also, they could have just sealed the deal with that. I'm not quite sure why he's just switching over to Hog now.
Yeah, very interesting decision. I think they could at least gone in with at least one more push, one more fight, using that Graviton. Because if you're able to take out one or two with that Pulse Bomb, pairing it with the Graviton, you could win that fight and win the map.
What a great sequence by Austin, actually. The Pulse Bomb and then the Flame Strike going out onto Snow Crash. Immediately Earth Shatters right after, catching everybody behind them. Looks like...
Yeah, look.
If Austin's just going to be able to take this. If they're able to clean up this Lucio that's sitting on the points.
Yeah, this fight is definitely going to go in favor of UT Austin here. It's... There's not a whole lot that San Antonio can do. At this point, they need to regroup, just take a couple seconds to regroup and come back in as a team. They're not going to be able to wait for Notkale. He's going to come in too slowly.
Oh, what a good block.
Oh.
Snow Crash getting burst down immediately despite the nano boost. Now it's just an all-out brawl, but Austin's just going to have the positional advantage and able to take down everybody.
Yeah, that was a very good job from UT Austin there. San Antonio, they had a lot to work with on that initial take, but after that, they didn't have a whole lot of firepower to work with. On that kill on Bean from Keep It Cute was able to stall them just a little bit, but I don't know, it just, the skirmishes almost always went in favor of UT Austin if there were no alts in the mix, so I'm interested to see how this is going to go, because the initial fights almost always go in favor of UT Austin. I think mechanically they just have a slight leg up against San Antonio. If I'm forgetting that right, am I said San Antonio? Anyway, Austin has a slight leg up from San Antonio, but
right, the engage is just so crisp. You just see these little interactions going so well every time. Excellent's going to be on to Winston once again.
And he might fall here early. There he goes. Yep, he was going to be flashbanged. There was not a lot he can do there, but Tchaikovsky is going to take out Shogunai, so it's going to be 5v5. Let's see who that's going to favor here, but I don't know. They're trading quite a bit. Not a whole lot, you know, not a whole lot going on. It's pretty much just one, you know, one for one. It's pretty much how it's going. Wow.
Tchaikovsky already on sitting on a barrage, and despite being even in the fight, UT San Antonio was just getting pushed back into their spawn by all that pressure from Tchaikovsky, Bean, and Talnori. Talnori almost sitting on another Dragon Blade, on a Dragon Blade, so this next fight could just be a rout.
Yeah, see here, Snow Crash is going to get pretty low, but it looks like Awake Eevee is going to be able to get him back up, but I wonder if they're going to... This would be one of the times I would think to see... Oh, Bean is going to be able to take out Awake Eevee with that Pulse Bomb. I'm surprised that there's the Dragon Blade. I'm surprised to not see it earlier, especially with them grouped up so much in that small room.
Right, and I actually disagree with that Dragon Blade. I think they were up maybe two or three people. They could have gone with no more ults.
Yes, that late in the fight, I think it was a questionable usage. I'm surprised I didn't see it earlier, because they were all in a very enclosed space, so each swing, you're going to hit at least three or four people. So I think at that point, it was just a little bit late, and he could have held on to it just a little bit longer, but
now,
they do have
another Pulse Bomb. Excellent has with the Primal Rage also. Just wreaking havoc in the backline. As soon as he pops his Primal Rage, which goes down right now, this blue team is just not going to have their push. Snowcrash ain't pushed all the way back.
I was kind of hoping he was just going to hit him off the edge, but that's not going to happen. He's going to have to bubble up just to save himself. But that was a very good defense there, keeping him off the point, especially keeping that Reinhardt off the point, not allowing him to Earth Shatter. Because having Earth Shattering just a single one, not be what you want.
Multiple ults coming out from both teams, Barrage and Dragon Blade coming out from Austin. And a nano boost is going to be going down onto Shogunai, who popped his attack visor. Res is going to come down. Looks like Bean's going to be able to take down Notkale. And Austin's just going to go up in this fight, probably going to take this round and the match.
Yeah, I think Snow Crash held on to that Earth Shatter just a little bit too long. There weren't a whole lot of places to use it, but the way I see it, there could have been at least one or two situations where even if you just get the Mercy or maybe the Far Mercy, because they're going to stick close together for a lot of the time, just Earth Shatter at least one of them just to make sure you can take one out. If you can take out that Mercy, then that res that just happened there, which turned the numbers back in favor of UT Austin, that you could have stopped that from happening, but because there wasn't a whole lot of grouping up happening for UT Austin, I think they had to realize that he did have the Earth Shatter.